إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، في أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. دين الإسلام، our religion Islam honor the human being. Allah سبحانه وتعالى created Adam عليه السلام with his own hands. At the day of judgment, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم told us what is going to happen. People will go to Adam عليه الصلاة والسلام. Then they will say, O Adam, أنت أبو البشر خلقك الله بيده وأسجد لك ملائكتك وعلمك أسماء كل شيء. People will say to Adam, You are Adam, the father of mankind. And Allah created you with his own hands and ordered the angels to prostrate before you, and he taught you the names of all things. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored our father Adam alayhi salatu wa salam. And this is an honor for all of his children generally. So Islam honors the human being by giving him the mind, not like the animals. And we should use it in the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. Islam is the religion. If they say human rights, it is there in Islam before them in 100 or 1,000 years. Islam is the religion of justice. وَتَمَّتْ كَلِمَةُ رَبِّكَ صِدْقًا وَعَدْلًا. And the word of your Lord has been fulfilled in truth and in justice. So all the rules in Islam, all of them, rules of inheritance, rules of punishment, rules of the divorce, all the rules, rules of justice. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent for the all mankind. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا كَافَّةً لِلنَّاسِ بَشِيرًا وَنَذِيرًا. And we have not sent you except to mankind as a bringer of good tidings and a warner. عليه الصلاة والسلام. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted us this religion. And he uprooted this religion for us. رَضِيَ ذَلِكَ الدِّينَ لَنَا. Anyone meets Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the other than Islam will not be accepted from him. وَمَنْ يَبْتَغَ غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينَ فَلَيُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ وَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. There are rules in this religion. There are things which are wajib, compulsory. To make the hayah, the life, to go smooth with justice and peace. And one of the things is حفظ نفس الإنسان. To preserve, to protect the soul of the person. How? By making the killing one of the major sins. من أجل ذلك كتبنا على بني إسرائيل أنه من قتل نفسا بغير نفس أو فساد في الأرض فكأنما قتل الناس جميعا. سبحان الله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that for بني إسرائيل, and also this is for us. Because of that we decreed upon the children of Israel that whoever kills a soul, unless for a soul or for corruption done in the land, it is as if he had slain mankind entirely. So this is one of the things in Islam, when you speak about the human rights, كزين الإسلام rules from Allah سبحانه وتعالى حرام strictly forbidden. ومن يقتل مؤمنا متعمدا فجزاؤه جهنم خالدا فيها وغضب الله عليه ولعنه وعد له عذابا عظيما. But whoever kills a believer intentionally, his recompense is hell, wherein he will abide eternally, and Allah has become angry with him and has cursed him and has prepared for him a great punishment. To respect the human being without right, killing without right, this is one of the major sins in Islam. Not only that, even when you kill yourself, committing suicide, this is one of the major sins. Islam respects the soul of the human being. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, من قتل نفسه بحديدة جاء يوم القيامة وحديدته في يده يتوجأ بها في بطني في نار جهنم خالدا مخلدا أبدا. Whoever kills himself with an instrument of iron, he will come on the day of judgment with his iron stomach, with his iron in his hand to continually stab himself in his stomach with it in the fire of judgment, dwelling in that state eternally as a punishment of the day of judgment. So that's why it is haram, not allowed, strictly forbidden to think about committing suicide. You should be patient and you should accept the qadr from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also one of the rights in Islam for the human being, حق الكرامة, to honor the human being. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and we have certainly honored the children of Adam. Honor. You have a brain, you can think, you can decide, you choose. Not like animals. This is an honor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored the human being by giving him the chance to use what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created on the ground, on the earth. أَلَمْ تَرَوْا أَنَّ اللَّهَ سَخَّرَ لَكُمْ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَأَسْبَغَ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعَمَهُ ظَاهِرَةً وَبَاطِنَةً. Do you not see that Allah has made subject to you whatever is in the heavens and and whatever is in the earth, and applied, bestowed upon you his favors? This is an honor for the human being. And also one of the rights, the human rights in Islam, al-hurriya, the freedom. But you should be very careful when you speak about this term, because many people misuse this term. Yes, you have the freedom to choose, where to work, where to live. But it should be within the Sharia borders. You should not oppress others. You should not ridicule others. You have the freedom in Islam to choose your religion, la ikraha fi al-deen. Yes, it is wajib, it is compulsory for every single person from jinn and ins to worship Allah alone subhanahu wa ta'ala. But our job to give him the da'wah. We cannot make him forcefully to accept Islam. لا إكراه في الدين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, there shall be no compulsion in acceptance of the religion. So in Islam you have the freedom, but not to bother the others. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned the hadith. This is a very important hadith to explain for us the meaning of freedom in Islam. Or where to stop, what are the borders for you? He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَثَلْ قَامْ عَلَىٰ حُدُودِ اللَّهِ وَالْوَاقَعْ فِيهَا. What is the example of the one who is following the rules of Islam and the one who is not following, disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So this is the wrong freedom when you disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The likeness of the man who observes the limits prescribed by Allah and that of the man who transgresses them is like the people who get on board a ship. After casting lots, some of them are in the lower deck and some of them in its upper deck. Those who are in its lower deck, when they require water, go to the occupants of the upper deck and say to them, If we make a hole on the bottom, if we make a hole at the bottom of the ship, we shall not harm you. This is the wrong understanding of freedom. حرية. Let's make a hole in the bottom. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if the occupants of the upper deck left them in doing that, what will happen? All of them were going to die. If you follow this way of understanding freedom, let them do whatever they like. This is their part. So the whole community will die. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وَإِنْ أَخَذُوا عَلَىٰ أَيْدِيهِمْ نَجَوْا وَنَجَوْا جَمِيعًا. But if they don't let them go ahead with their plan, all of them will remain safe. This is the freedom in Islam. You do whatever you like, but without harming others, without disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the freedom of believing. وَلَوْ شَاءَ رَبُّكَ لَآمَنَ مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ كُلُّهُمْ جَمِيعًا أَفَأَنْتَ تُكْرِهُ النَّاسِ حَتَّى يَكُونُوا مُؤْمِنِينَ. And had your Lord willed, those on earth would have believed all of them entirely. Then, O Muhammad, would you compel the people in order that they become believers? He cannot force them, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They have the freedom to choose the religion, but they should know what is going to happen for them in the day of judgment. One of the human rights, al-adalah, the justice. The justice in Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُ بِالْعَدْلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ وَإِيْتَاءِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى. Indeed, Allah orders justice and good conduct and giving help to relatives and forbids immorality. So this is one of the main things in Islam. The human rights, al-adl, justice. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَلَا إِمَّا رَبَّكُمْ وَاحِدٌ. Your Lord is one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِنَّ أَبَاكُمْ وَاحِدٌ. And also your father is one. Adam, alayhi salatu wa salam. Which means, when you are talking to your friend or to another person from another country, from another nationality, you should remember, we go to the same origin, Adam, our father, our father. He's my father, your father, father of people in America and Europe and Indonesia, everywhere. You go to the same father, Adam. Then he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is the point to mention that introduction? He means, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لا فضل لعربي على أعجمي. There is no preference of an Arab over a non-Arab. Or the opposite. وَلَا أَحْمَرْ عَلَىٰ أَسْوَدْ. أحمر means red, or أسود means black. Then he said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, إِلَّا بِالتَّقْوَى. Except according to your piety, righteousness. You are better than him because of your salah, your charity, your behavior, your fasting, not your color, your nationality, your wealth. This is Islam. Islam gives us the freedom and learning. And this is compulsory. طلب العلم فريضة على كل مسلم. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, seeking knowledge is a duty upon every Muslim. To seek the knowledge of what is useful, of course, on top of them, the Islamic knowledge, this is the meaning of the hadith. And also, it is needed to learn what is useful for the Muslim ummah and for the human being. Also, one of the right to work. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, هُوَ الَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُمُ الْأَرْضَ ذَلُولًا فَامْشُوا فِي مَنَاكِبِهَا وَكُلُوا مِنْ رِزْقِهِ وَإِلَيْهِ النُّشُورِ. It is He who made the earth tame for you, so walk among its slopes and eat of His provision, and to Him is the resurrection. Should work to earn money. And the best thing to earn money with your hands, as the Prophet Dawood alayhi salatu wasalam, He used to earn money through his hands. He was working with his hands. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ما كسب الرجل كسبا أطيب من عمل يده. The best thing to earn is through your hands. When you farm, when you make things and you sell them, the halal things, this is the best way to earn money. وما أنفق الرجل على نفسه وأهله وولده وخادم فهو صدقة. Whatever you spend on yourself, your wife, your children, your maid, this is charity. This is charity. So this is Islam, the human rights before what the nations do now, and they are not following what they are saying. Also, one of the very important points in Islam that you have to perfect your deeds. إِنَّ اللَّهُ يُحِبُّ إِذَا عَمِلَ أَحَدُكُمْ عَمَلًا أَمْ يُتْقِنَ. Allah likes the one who is doing his job to perfect his job. You are a teacher, follow the best way to teach your students. You are a doctor, you should follow the best way to treat your patients. You are a mother, you are a father, follow the best way to fulfill your job at home or outside. This is part of Islam, to perfect your deeds. Also, one of the rights in Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من ترك مالا فلورثته ومن ترك كلا فإلينا. He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if somebody dies leaving some property, the property will go to his heirs, to his inheritors, his children, his wife, his parents. This is your own wealth. You can enjoy that. If it is the opposite, someone dies with debt or dependence, we will take care of them. So you'll find Islam supporting you if you are in need. Also in Islam, one of the rights that you have the right to own a car, to own a property, to own the things. حق التملك, this is called حق التملك. And it is not allowed to take that without a right. Because كل المسلم على المسلم حرام. دمه وماله وعرضه. Every Muslim over the other Muslim, haram to touch his wealth or his soul or his earth. Don't touch his honor. Don't speak about his wife or his family in a bad way. Don't take his money without right. And also don't shed his blood or don't kill him. This is some of the rights in Islam. أقول ما تسمعون واستغفر الله. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده ما بعد. One of the rights of Islam, the freedom in thinking and speaking. In thinking and speaking, you will find in Islam, أَفَلَا يَعْقِلُونَ أَفَلَا يَنْظُرُونَ أَفَلَا تَسْمَعُونَ. You don't reason. But again and again and again, it should be within the limits of Islam. When you speak, you have the freedom to speak, but don't ridicule others. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا يَسْخَرْ قَوْمٌ مِّن قَوْمٍ عَسَى يَكُونُ خَيْرًا مِّنْهُمْ. Don't ridicule others. You mock them. You laugh on them. Haram in Islam. Very clear in the Quran. Or you don't insult. You don't curse. The freedom is your speech or thinking. But again, it should be within the limits of Islam. When you think about others, you should think good about other Muslims. Not only that. Also, there are rights for the non-Muslims. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, أَلَا مَنْ ظَلَمَ مُعَاهَدًا أَوْ انْتَقَصَهُ أَوْ كَلَّفَهُ قَطَاقَتِهِ أَوْ أَخَذَ مِنْهُ شَيْئًا بِغَيْرِ طِيبِ نَفْسٍ فَأَنَا حَجِيجُهُ يوم القيامة. He said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if anyone wrongs a man with whom a covenant has been made, a Christian who lives for a non-Muslim lives in a Muslim country, it is haram to wrong him.
He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if anyone wrongs a man with whom a covenant has been made, or curtails any right of his, or imposes on him more than he can bear, or takes anything from him without his ready agreement, I shall be his adversary on the day of resurrection. Can you imagine the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will defend that man against you because you wronged him? It doesn't mean this man will be in paradise and he is better than the Muslims. Never. But the religion of justice, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned. So in Islam, you will find everything that we need for our life, our worldly life and the hereafter. The issue is we need to read. We need to believe in the Quran and the Sunnah. We need to follow, we need to spread what is mentioned in the Quran and Sunnah, and we will be happy in this worldly life and also in the hereafter. Allahumma aghfir lil mu'minin wal mu'minat, wal muslimin wal muslimat, al ahya'i minhum wal amwat, innaka sami'un qarib, mujibud da'wat ya rabbal alamin. Allahumma ij'al hadha al balada amina mutma'inna wa sa'ira bilad al muslimin. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان جعلنا اللهم من الراشدين اللهم بلغنا رمضان اللهم بلغنا رمضان اللهم بلغنا رمضان وعنا على صيامه وقيامه واقتلاوة القرآن آناء الليل وأطراف النهار والصدقة يا رب العالمين اللهم نجي إخوان المسلمين في كل مكان اللهم نجي إخوان المسلمين المضطهدين في كل مكان نجي إخوان المسلمين في فلسطين اجعل فلسطين آمنة مطمئنة واجعل صلاتنا في البيت في المسجد الأقصى صلاة آمنة مطمئنة يا رب العالمين استر عوراتهم وآمن روعاتهم في فلسطين وفي كل مكان يا رب العالمين وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.